You know, in the Bible, there are the great heroes, great preachers. Apollos, the Bible says, was a man mighty in the scriptures who powerfully refuted the Jews and in public, proving from the scriptures that Jesus was the Christ. Powerful preacher. Peter and John obviously were significant preachers, and the people looked to those three as the greats. But there were many others, and there are those that behind the scenes were probably just as great and in many ways very impacting, and yet very little is known about them. One of these is a guy who for me is a bit of a hero. His name is Epaphras. He is the quiet achiever. Epaphras is a guy that just got on with the job, and he was a cellmate, or he's locked up with Paul. He was a worker with Paul. He was there committed. He was delivering stuff for Paul. But he was much more than that. Epaphras was truly an apostle of God. And I want to pick up a story here in the book of Colossians. And it's in verse 12, Colossians chapter 4 and verse 12. And it says, Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, salutes you, always laboring fervently for you in prayer, that you might stand perfect, mature, totally complete, brought to a place where you are. Actually, the word for complete there is the word pleroo, which means filled to overflowing, filled with the fullness of God and the power of God. This guy prayed constantly that his people and the people of the churches he was with would be absolutely mature and absolutely filled with the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. He was unselfish and he was passionate about those around him. And the scripture says, for I bear him record that he has a great zeal for you and also for those in Laodicea and those that are in Hierapolis. So here's this interesting guy. This man, we know, went down into the Lycus Valley and opened the great churches at Laodicea and also Hierapolis and also Colossae. He opened the three churches and he was concerned for them. He was an apostle there, but he held them in prayer. And he was a man who was intense in prayer. The Bible says that he labored fervently. That's a powerful word in the Greek language. It's agonizomai, and it's the word from which we get agony. But it is a struggle. It is a contested struggle. It is a striving, an intense, passionate striving in prayer for something to happen. He had on his heart that his people were not just going to be Christians in church, but they were going to be brought to completeness. He was driven in prayer to pray that those around him would grow in strength and grow in the anointing and grow to a place where they're mature, where they're moving as Christ, where Christ is being formed in them, as Paul would say, and that they are complete. Now, that word complete in the Greek is pleroo, which means filled to overflowing. In Ephesians, we read the prayer of Paul that we might be filled with all the fullness of God, filled with all the fullness of God. Paul loved that term. He loved that term, fullness, and it's used here again in this writing to the Colossian church. But Paul is saying, this guy, just like me, wants you mature, strong, standing firm, standing immovable, and absolutely filled to overflowing with the fullness of God himself. This guy labored earnestly. There's something about people who know how to pray for others. I think we all pray for ourselves and our family, but there's something about those that give their life to interceding and crying out for others, that have a passion not to pray for themselves so much, but to pray that others around them would come to their fullness, encouraging others around to rise up to a new dimension, encouraging other people nearby and saying, hey, if I possibly can, I want you to come to a place of great strength, great faith, great maturity, where you too can go out and do great things for God. That's a challenge to all of us, to be fervent in prayer for others. But it goes on from there, and I love what it says. It says, for I bear him record Paul says, I put this on record. I'm actually emphasizing and overemphasizing this. I put it on serious record that he has a great zeal for you, that he has a great zeal for you and everyone in Laodicea and everyone in Hierapolis. A great zeal. The word polos, huge, huge zeal. The word zeal is from the word zealous, which is translated heat, ardor, jealousy, fervency of mind, almost an indignation. And it comes from the word zeo, to be boiling hot, like boiling liquids. This is a boiling heat. We begin to get the feel of this man, and we find out that he earnestly agonizes for them. And not only is he agonizing for them, but Paul says, I bear you record. I want you to know about this man, that what he has for you is not just a love, but he has a boiling over white heat. He is jealous for you. He is zealous for you. He wants the best for you. He wants the power of God on you. You know, something happens in the body of Christ when we all begin to say, hey, I'm not just about what I'm doing, about my ministry, about my impact, but we begin to say, Father, would you anoint those around me? Would you anoint them? Would you raise them up? Would you put your power in them? I think at the end of this whole thing, our success is not just going to be measured by what we've done, but it'll be measured by those that we have prayed for, helped and encouraged and zealously stirred to rise up to fulfill their destiny in Christ. My prayer for you is this decade, that you would be strengthened, that you'd come to completeness, that you'd be filled with the Holy Ghost and power. Father, I'm asking you that you would give me a burning zeal for everyone around me. I love seeing kids raised up on our trips. I love seeing people around us growing and moving out in the miraculous and seeing the power of God. I love to see people developing under the hand of God. That has to be our aim. This man, Epaphras, is an incredible example, a great giant, in my opinion, from the first century church, one from whom we can learn much. May we become like Epaphras of old. May we grow to have the impact like him and be filled with that same zeal. I'm going to pray for you today. And Father, I do pray for every person listening now to what I'm sharing. I pray that your hand would come on them significantly, that you would raise them up, you'd bring them to completeness, and you'd place a mighty charge of the supernatural of God on every one of their lives. I thank you for it now. I ask you to touch them and bless them. Use them in a significant way, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.